Hello and welcome to this episode of Forkful of Noodles. I am Krish Mohan. Love is in the air. At the Grammys this year, 33 gay couples got wed by Queen Latifah, which is great to see forward momentum being taken in the issue of gay marriage, but that also means that we're going to take a couple steps backwards since Twitter exploded with nasty comments. At Garen_Allen says, "These Grammys turned out to be a damn fag/queer marriage festival. Hashtag gross." Which one is it, Alan? Is it a fag convention or is it a queer convention? Figure it out. Find out who you're hating. Get a little bit more information. You know, that's like calling Lollapalooza the same thing as Bonnaroo. And second of all, what about the Grammys? Is straight or normal? Is it Elton John? Is it Queen? Is it the fact that people have robot heads and dance around and there's a DJ spinning what seems to be a meat disc? That's not normal or straight, I'm pretty sure. And as for the fag part, I mean, I would expect this from the CMAs. They have a big issue with black presidents, brown people on internet shows, so homophobia, that's just natural progression for them. At _BrookeXO_ says, "I said to Mom, 'You still watching the Grammy Awards?' She texted back and said, 'I was until this fag started singing.'" One, why are you texting your mom about the Grammys? If you were a better person, you would actually have friends to text to. And why are you worried about the Grammys or some pop culture award? Who cares? That should be the last thing on your mind. And why is your mom getting involved in this? Didn't her music end in 1969? Basically, what it looks like is you need a better mom because your mom sounds like a shitty person. You should put up Craigslist ads and classified ads to see if you can find a better mom and hold interviews. Maybe you'll find a much less judgmental lesbian mom that'll suit you better. At Bergen_Banward says, "The whole gay wedding thing just murdered the Grammys. Hashtag not cool." Actually, the Grammys killed the Grammys. You know, over the last couple of years, there's just been this outpour of shitty music and shitty people commenting on real issues. It really shows how far society has fallen. So really, it's your fault. You're the reason why the Grammys are dead. Despite all this hate on Twitter, gay marriage is still taking some forward steps. Like 5 states plus Washington DC legalizing gay marriage. But there are 19 states that let you marry your own cousin without any legal objection. So, to be clear, same grandmother, okay. Brother from another mother, not cool. Now that's a good way to get gay marriage in all communities. You know, there's a loophole for you. All gay people have to do is find a cousin, convince them that they're gay with what ultra-conservatives call the gay voodoo magic, and then boom, there you go, gay marriage. And now Catholics won't have an issue with this because, let's be honest, one Catholic doesn't have a very attractive cousin in their family that they wouldn't want to have 8 to 12 children with, huh? I mean, it's even in the Bible, and I'm going to quote and say, "Hey bro, it doesn't count if you have your shirt on," and that's Leviticus 69:12, or it's in the deleted scenes of the Bible is where it is. If you look into deleted scenes, that's where it is. Two of the states that have no issues with gay or straight cousin marriage is Vermont and Massachusetts. Now that makes sense because they're New England states, and in England, people used to marry their cousins all the time to make sure that their bloodlines were kept within the family.
Hell yeah, brother! We gotta keep those Camaro bloodlines strong and free!
Sorry, have we met before?
Are you serious? Have we met?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, we've met, Chris.
Krish.
Yeah, we've definitely met. My brother told me to come down here. It's where I get some headshots done.
Whoa,
I want to be
shit.
A movie star like you, brother.
What, are you that shirtless jackass's brother?
First of all, don't you be talking about my family like that. My brother, don't talk about him. And, well, technically, he's also my cousin.
Wait, what? How does that even... Yeah.
Well, like I said, were you not paying attention? We gotta keep those Camaro bloodlines strong and free. We do a little bit of the old intertwining in my family.
Right.
I don't think you're gay. That was sex.
I get what that is. It's sex.
It's a metaphor.
That's literal. Not a metaphor, but...
Yeah, both. I think.
Great. Okay. You know what? That's cool. You got. I mean, you guys want to marry your cousins.
Marry?
It's weird, but that's...
Bang each other? We don't care.
Yeah, I mean, that's right. The marriage... Everybody wants to get married, right? I think more homosexuals should get married. More states should allow homosexuals to get
homosexuals?
Married.
Homosexuals? Yeah, I don't care about the homosexuals, Chris.
No.
I don't care at all, baby. I even sometimes think about marrying my brother cousin.
Your brother cousin?
My brother cousin.
One with the nips.
Yeah, he got them pretty little tiny nipples. Looks like you just slapped two brown dimes on the man's chest. I like that, right? I even recently asked him. I said, hey, cuz. And he said, what, brother? I said, we should go up to my cabin in Vermont, do a little bit of hanging out. But he's real weird about putting the shirt on, and it's kind of chilly up there.
It is.
And I even said, hey, you can sit in the truck inside the front of the truck, not in the back like I normally put them when we're driving around here, because you're allowed to drink beer when you're in the back of a truck.
Not true.
In Pennsylvania.
That is false.
Yeah, well, that's what my daddy told me. I was even willing to move all my stuff off the front seat, my crossbow, my pistol, my shotgun, my NASCAR shirt.
Excessive. That is an excessive amount of things for a front seat.
Just hunting equipment.
Five shirts for hunting season.
Well, yeah, what if, you know.
All right.
What if you get some deer blood on one of the shirts?
Fine, to each his own. To each his own.
To eat his own.
Like if you're eating
your own family or something.
So
like
did
that.
You get to go up to Vermont with the brothers?
Nah, he turned me down. It's the shirt thing.
Really? That's sad, yeah. Man. I really feel for you there. I feel bad for you.
You feel for me?
A little bit, yeah.
All right, well, you know what, buddy? I might be going up to the cabin this weekend if you want to join.
Oh, man, I got so many things going on. I have, like, a party that I need to do. I have a dog somewhere.
We can party up at the cabin. I'll grab a case of wine coolers.
I'm lactose intolerant.
Skinnered in the tape deck.
Only like T.I. I'm just a big T.I. fan. Yeah, he's a rapper. Hey, is that somebody's up?
Oh, my God. Trucks. Hey, where'd he go? Get back here, man. I'm gonna find you, baby.
Alright. Look, there's still a long way to go in this uphill battle for gay marriage. There are still 44 states that need to legalize gay marriage in this country. And I think the best way to do it is if gay people go on Twitter and start bashing weird straight people. Thank you very much for joining me on this episode of Forkful of Noodles. We will see you next week. Check out everything we do at ramennoodlescomedy.com. Have a good one.